Hi, I'm Amir from TechTree.com, and today we have for you the Zolo Q700 smartphone. You may remember Zolo from over a year ago because they were the first ones to launch an Intel-based smartphone in India. Now that's an old story. Now let's take a look at this one, which happens to be a quad-core smartphone based on Android under 10,000 rupees. For starters, the phone looks quite classy and elegant. Now, in a sub 10K range, you generally expect a plasticky phone, but this one thankfully is not. The construction is quite sturdy, it's good to hold, and there is this matte, soft touch matte finish at the back, which feels quite good. And in this phone, they've used a brown shade, which is a little unusual as compared to most of the phones that you get in the market, but it does look good. The Q700 comes with a 4.5-inch IPS display with a resolution of 960 by 540 pixels. Now this one incorporates something called as OGS technology, which means one glass solution. Essentially what it does is it reduces the space between the upper protective glass and the LCD inside, which makes the display a lot more closer to you and it looks a little more livelier. Now the screen here is quite sharp and the colors are vibrant too. The contrast is pretty decent as well, but the sunlight legibility is just about okay, but gets the job done. Now let's talk about the USP of this device, which I mentioned briefly at the start. This one comes with a 1.2 GHz quad-core processor from MediaTek and 1 GB of RAM. Now that's quite impressive for a phone that's priced under 10,000 rupees. Now generally when you get a sub 10K phone, either you get a dual-core processor or 512 MB of RAM, which I personally feel is not enough for an Android device. But this one comes with 1 GB of RAM, which should be perfect. In addition to that, you also get 4 GB of internal storage, of which about 2.5 GB is usable. And of course, there's a micro USB card slot to expand it further by 32 GB. On the software front too, the Q700 doesn't lag behind. It comes with the latest Android Jelly Bean 4.2 OS and with minimum customization from Zolo, almost no customization I would say, which means it would be very easy to adapt to if you've used an Android phone before. In addition to that, Zolo have thrown in a few useful apps of their own. Now to name a couple would be Zolo Secure, which is like an anti-theft mechanism, and Zolo Switch, which allows you to create multiple users using multiple IDs like you generally do on your desktop PC or laptop. And of course, there's a very interesting kids mode, which is very handy if you have Angry Birds loving kids at your place, which basically allows you to disable your calling, your messaging and everything else and allows them to just play games on this phone. Let's move on to the performance. Now all the impressive hardware that this device flaunts does deliver, and we had very little to complain about except for the occasional lag that you associate with most of the Android devices, but nothing that really put us off. As far as gaming on this device is concerned, we tried running a couple of popular games like Angry Birds, Star Wars and Temple Run 2, and they ran perfectly fine here without a lag, so we have nothing to complain about on the gaming front as well. So the overall performance of this device is quite impressive, and in fact, it's a little better than its elder sibling, the Q800, which is priced at around 1500 rupees more than the Q700. Last but not the least, the multimedia performance of this device, starting with the camera. Now this one comes with a 5 megapixel camera with autofocus and LED flash. The picture quality is pretty decent, but nothing spectacular. In well-lit environments, the pictures do come out well, but there is a bit of sharpening that Zolo has added to the algorithm which kills it at times, but nothing too bad. However, in low-lit conditions, the pictures are not so great and they are a bit too grainy for my taste. The camera is also capable of recording 720p videos and they come out pretty well as long as the lighting is good. However, at times they are also a victim of the over-sharpening algorithm that I mentioned previously. The phone comes with a 2400 mAh battery that lasts you easily for a day and a half, and that can be termed as quite a good battery life for an Android device. The Zolo Q700 is priced at just under 10,000 rupees with a 1-year warranty in India. Now this may not be a perfect phone, but at that price point, we don't want to be overly critical of it. And especially given the fact that there are not many phones that can compete with this in the sub 10K mark. So having taken all that into consideration, we would rate this phone at 4 out of 5 stars. That's it for now. If you like this video, do drop us a line and let us know. And of course, keep watching this space for more gadget reviews and the latest tech stuff.